fourth example of Sunni morality. A Salafi woman, which means a Sunni woman, she can suckle a man with a beard. And this is true. Muhammad, if you remember, Muhammad in the hadith, a woman, she came to him, her name is Sahla bint Suhail. And she said to him that my husband is unhappy with the slaves we have in our house, a man, a grown man, who look at me in a dirty way. So what I shall do? And this is, by the way, this is Sahih. The Muslim, they cannot say. So the woman, Sahla bint Suhail, she came to the Prophet and she said to him, I see in the face of Abu Hudhayfa a displeasure. He is unhappy for having this guy in our house. He's a man. The Messenger of Allah said, not the women, not the neighbor. This is God talking, because Muhammad, he speak always for God. When he make a rule, this is a God ruling. He said to her, okay, do for him breastfeeding. Breastfeed him. The woman, she said, what? How I can do breastfeeding for him when he is a growing man? If you go to the house of Shabir Ali, oh, forget Shabir Ali, Zakir Naik, or any Muslim cleric, and you are a stranger, based on the teaching of the Prophet, his wife, she have to give her boobs to you, and you have to suck it 10 different times until you are satisfied. And by the way, this is not only in the hadith, this is, was a verse in the Quran. If you remember, the goat ate the verse. Muhammad, he made that as a Quran from God. This is not just a hadith. But sadly, the goat, I don't believe, by the way, that the goat ate this verse. I believe the Muslims, they took it off, because it's a shameful. If we go in the hadith, we find this, confirming the adult feeding, breastfeeding. Aisha, she said, that the verses, as you see, it's a verse of a stoning to death and of a breastfeeding for adult, 10 times, 10 times. Which means if you have a wife and you are a Muslim and you want Christian prince to enter your house, you have to order your wife to give her boobs to Christian prince 10 times, to suck it in 10 different days. And he have to do it 10 times until he is satisfied. Not only like for 2 minutes, no. I have to be satisfied, otherwise it's not accepted, it's not halal. Hey guys, I'm going to visit Muhammad Hijab next week. Who is going to go with me? This is Islam. They give us a presentation and speeches about morality and conservative and our women and your women, but this is Islam. We cannot see a woman's face, but we can suck her boobs. I mean, this is very conservative. Actually, I was thinking to open a project in Las Vegas, like I will open a drive-through suckling. Halal. You know, like we hire some good believing women in Islam, and we do drive-through suckling, and women, they give their nipples, and like you are in the car, and you make a lot of money. Halal, it's halal. They are strangers. And this was the Quran. Actually, if you search right now, for the fatwa for a breastfeeding for adult, you will find that the dean of the University of Al-Azhar made a fatwa about it. And the Muslims, they made a big fuss about it. Like, why are you talking about? What are you talking about? You know, he said to them, shut up. This is what the Prophet said. Even Aisha herself, she asked her sister to do suckling for anyone want to enter upon her. This is the fatwa and this is the issue. But here, speaking about Saudi Arabia, but the big fatwa is made by the dean of the University of Al-Azhar, the dean of the Hadith department. And when everybody accuses him, what are you talking about? The Muslims are ignorant. They do not know what this is. This is Islam. He said to them, what's wrong with you? The Prophet, he ordered that. Even Aisha, she used to do breastfeeding by ordering her sister as a secretary. So people before they enter upon her, they have to suckle her sister boobs. Imagine visiting the wife of the Prophet at that time. How fun is going to be for many perverted men. Aisha, by the way, she used to take a shower naked in the front of strangers. Read this hadith with me. Narrated Abu Salama, Aisha, brother, and I and I went to Aisha and he asked her about the bath of the Prophet. She brought a pot containing about, water, and took a bath and poured over her. I mean, she wanna show them how to do it. And between us and her, look, it says here, between us and her is a screen. So this is a screen you can see through. And she is teaching them how he used to take a bath. Who? The brother of Aisha and his friend. Let us show you the hadith about Aisha ordering her sister to do breastfeeding. And this is sahih. Read with me. That Aisha, hence Aisha, may Allah pleased with her, used to ask the daughter of her sisters, the daughters of her sister, and the daughters of her brethren to give him breastfeeding 5 times, whom Aisha wanted to see and who wanted to visit her. And you have to do it here. They said that this is abrogated. It was 10 times, but the Prophet, he made it 5 times. But we cannot find the verse of 5 times in the Quran too. So you have to suck their boobs 5 times in order to see Her Majesty Aisha. Mean. I'm so glad that Trump is not a Muslim. Otherwise, the White House will be lined up with men who want to suckle the sisters of Melania Trump. Trump, I want to see you. Trump, President Trump, I'm going to visit you tomorrow. President Trump, are you coming? Is the blonde girls waiting there for me? Can I take a date now? I want to go. And they say to us, Islam is a conservative religion. I mean, what kind of madness this madness is? Look, but Umm Salama, she refused other wives of the Prophet, she refused to allow anyone to visit them in the basis of such a breastfeeding. So Aisha was the only one practicing as Allah, he said, and as the Prophet said.